Yo, what's going on, guys? Camille here. So this is actually the third time we have a Childe banner rerun. It's like kind of a rerun, you can say. So if this banner ends and you still hadn't gotten Childe by now, well then you're probably gonna wait a long time until we see him again. But I assume a lot of people already got him, so yeah, in this video I'm gonna be showing you guys how to build Childe as a main DPS or kind of a main DPS, and also as a burst sub DPS kind of. So yeah, without further ado, please don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and let's begin. Alright, so starting off with his talent priorities, for a main DPS build, all of the time you're probably gonna be like auto-attacking with Childe, but mainly you're gonna be auto-attacking his melee stance. You're not gonna be like auto-attacking from like with the bow with the range stance, you're gonna be auto-attacking in the melee stance. So your auto-attacks in the melee stance are gonna scale off your elemental skill, so that's gonna be your main priority. And then you wanna upgrade your elemental burst, and finally your like auto-attacks. Your actual auto attacks, you probably won't be using them like almost at all, so they're not necessary to upgrade. Now for a burst sub DPS build, obviously you'd want to upgrade your elemental burst, and then maybe you'd want to upgrade your elemental skill if you want to like auto attack sometimes or something like that. And then your auto attacks or like your actual auto attacks are not necessary to upgrade at all. But mainly your elemental burst is the only thing you're gonna need to upgrade. Now I'm gonna tell you guys some kind of tips you're gonna need to know when you're using Childe. The first tip is you'd want to stay in his elemental skill or like his melee stance for no more than 12 seconds. If you have him at C1, you can stay a little bit longer than that, maybe like 14 seconds. But if you have him at C0, 12 seconds is the way to go, because the more you stay, the longer cooldown you're gonna have on his elemental skill. And I generally find that 12 seconds is the best sweet spot you can stay in his elemental skill. If you stay longer than that, you're gonna have a way longer cooldown, and it's kind of like not worth it. But 12 seconds is the best time. You can stay a little bit less if you want, like 10 seconds or something like that, but like stay no more than 12 seconds at C0. The second thing you want to know, guys, is that Childe's charge attacks are very, very good. They deal a very good amount of damage, and they also don't consume a lot of energy, so you'd want to be using his charge attacks and your rotations. Generally, you'd want to do like 2 auto attacks or 2 normal attacks or 3 maybe, and then use a charge attack and repeat and repeat. That way you're not gonna run out of stamina, and you're gonna also take advantage out of the charge attacks damage in your rotations. The third and final thing you want to know, guys, is that the difference between his like elemental burst in the melee stance and in the range stance. So in the melee stance, that's just more damage, like that's it, that's the only benefit you're gonna have. But with the range stance, it deals less damage than that, but it's gonna like consume less energy because it's gonna refund you 20 energy, so that's pretty cool. That's gonna be pretty good on like a if you're using them as a sub DPS, you're not gonna be using them on the field for a long time, so that energy you're gonna get refunded is gonna be like pretty valuable. The range stance is also gonna deal more like AoE damage, you're gonna hit like more enemies with it. So if you have a grouping character and you can group the enemies together, like the range stance is probably gonna be better. The range stance is also like easier kind of to use, you can say, because you don't need to get into like your elemental skill to use it and stuff like that. With the melee stance, it can mess up your rotations, but in the range stance, it's just easy, like get energy and use it, and that's it. Now, to be honest, guys, I can't say which one is better. It just really depends on your teams, your playstyle, and stuff like that. But generally, I prefer the range stance for like a sub DPS Childe. It's gonna be like better because you're not gonna require a lot of energy, and also it's gonna be like pretty easy to like do it with your teams and stuff like that, because you're gonna be switching characters and all of that. But if you're want to do like more damage or want to like kill more enemies at like one shot and stuff like that, then the melee stance is going to be better. Generally, at the end of the day, it's just like your choice. Alright, so now let's move to his weapons. So for a DPS build, his best weapons are obviously going to be the 5 stars. His best weapon so far is the Polar Star, and then right after it is going to be the Thundering Pulse. These two weapons are kind of like pretty close to each other, to be honest. It really depends on your rotations and stuff like that, but generally speaking, the Polar Star is generally better in most situations, and then the Thundering Pulse is just right after it. Your third best weapon is going to be the Skyward, and then finally the Amos. Your best 4 4-star weapons are going to be the Viridescent Hunt, then the Prototype Crescent, then the Rust, and finally the Blacklight 4 Bow. The Slingshot is probably going to be your best 3-star option. Now, the Viridescent Hunt gives you a crit rate, so that's always pretty valuable. That's why I think it's the best 4-star option. The free-to-play Prototype Crescent is pretty good. The Rust is also pretty good, but you're going to need some refinements on it. So if you have like the Rust R5, that's probably the best 4-star option. But if you have the Rust at like refinement 1 or 2, it's probably not that good. The Blacklight is also pretty good. The passive is not really that easy to trigger, but generally speaking, it's also a pretty decent weapon. Now, for a sub DPS build, all of the other weapons are going to work too, but we're going to have some extra options. These options are going to be the Stringless, the Windbloom Ode, and finally the Alley Hunter. So the Stringless is going to increase your elemental burst damage and also your elemental mastery, which is pretty good for your sub DPS Childe. You'd want to vaporize his hit generally, so elemental mastery is going to be pretty useful, and obviously the elemental burst damage increase is going to be pretty useful. With the Windbloom, it's almost the same thing, just make sure you use your elemental skill before your elemental burst. The Alley Hunter, since you're not going to be using Childe on the field for a long time, it's also going to work too. So yeah, that was it for his weapons, guys. Now moving to artifacts. Now for a DPS build, his best artifact set is probably going to be the 4-piece Heart of Depth. This is definitely his best artifact set. It's like pretty much custom made for Childe. So yeah, this set is going to grant you the most damage. If you don't have the 4-piece Heart of Depth, you can use a 2-piece Heart of Depth and then a 2-piece of like 18% extra attack. Either the Gladiator or the Shimano is the same. This set combination is going to work too. It's not going to be as much damage as the 4-piece Heart of Depth, but it's also going to work if you don't have a 4-piece Heart of Depth. Now, for a sub DPS Childe, you can use the 4-piece Emblem of Severed Fate if you have more or equal to 160% energy recharge, which is recommended on Childe, especially sub DPS Childe. You'd want to have more than 160% or like around that at least. So in that case, the 4-piece Emblem of Severed Fate is going to be like a very good option. If you don't want to use the 4-piece Emblem of Severed Fate, you can use a 2-piece Noblesse and then a 2-piece Heart of Depth. So now for the stats on your artifacts. For a DPS Childe, you'd want to have attack percent on your sands, hydro damage bonus in your goblet, then crit rate or crit damage on your circlet. It's pretty simple and casual. For a sub DPS build, generally it's the same thing, but you might have elemental mastery on your sands. We're going to talk about how much elemental mastery you're going to need generally. So if you don't have that much elemental mastery already, you can use a elemental mastery sands. But generally speaking, attack percent is much more recommended. For the sub stats, you'd want to have crit rate and crit damage, then attack percent, then energy recharge, and finally elemental mastery. Now for the final stats you'd want to have on your Childe, crit rate is actually a little bit more valuable on Childe than like other characters because of the Riptide and stuff like that. So you'd want to have your crit rate at around 60-75%. Your crit damage, you'd want it to be around 120-150%, basically double of your crit rate. With energy recharge, you'd want it to sit around 150-175% or like 180%. Generally, that's going to be enough. If you're using him as a DPS, 140 or 130 might even be enough because he's going to be on the field for a very long time and he's going to be catching particles, so he's not going to need more energy. But if you're using him as a sub DPS, then you're going to need around like 170, 180, and you're going to be fine. Now, for the elemental mastery, I would say you'd want it to sit around like 150, and that's only for a sub DPS build. If you're using him as a DPS, he's going to be on the field for a long time. You're going to be auto attacking with him, and he's going to be applying hydro all of the time very, very fast. So he's usually not going to be the one who's triggering the reactions. So therefore, elemental mastery is going to be useless on DPS Childe. Well, not completely useless, but it's not like as valuable. But if you're using him as a sub DPS or like burst sub DPS, usually you'd want to like vaporize his elemental burst. So obviously, since you're going to be the one vaporizing with Childe, in that case, elemental mastery is going to be pretty useful. As I said, in that case, around 150 elemental mastery is going to be like the sweet spot, and it's going to be enough. Of course, including like if you have any elemental mastery buffers on your team like Sucrose, Albedo, or whatever. Alright, so now moving to his team comps. So there are a lot of like kind of team comps you can use with Childe, guys. We're gonna go through the most used ones, and yeah, let's begin. So the first team you can use with DPS Childe is gonna be a Electro Charge team. In that case, you're gonna need Childe and an Electro Enabler, and that's it. In that case, Childe is gonna be applying Hydro, and then the Electro Enabler is gonna be triggering Electro Charge when he does Electro. So yeah, team example for that, we're gonna have Childe as a main DPS, then Beidou as a sub DPS. DPS kind of. And then for example, we can add Raiden Shogun as a battery and to use her as like to do damage when Childe is down, and then Bennett. Obviously guys, in that team, make sure you use Beidou's ult with Childe's elemental skill and not with Raiden Shogun's elemental burst, because we all know they don't synergize well together. So yeah, use Beidou and Childe, do electro charge with Childe and Beidou, and then when you have Beidou's elemental burst and Childe's elemental skill on cooldown, you can use Raiden Shogun to generate more energy and also do some damage. The second team you can use on Childe is a vaporized team. It's pretty simple. You'd want to use Childe as a main DPS and then like a off-field pyro enabler, or pyro kind of DPS you can say. A team example for that is Childe as a main DPS, then Xiong Ling as a sub DPS or carry, and then Bennett and, for example, Sucrose. Well, to be honest guys, let's be honest with each other. I keep saying Childe is a main DPS on these teams, but to be honest, it's not really like a main DPS. A main DPS is like the character who does the most damage on the team. In all of those teams, almost, Childe is not gonna be like the one doing the most damage. He's just more of like a on-field enabler, you can say. He's not really like a main DPS. I keep saying he's a main DPS because you're gonna be using him like on the field, but technically he's not really the main DPS on this team. Xiong Ling is gonna be the main DPS on this team. Another team you can use on him as a DPS is a permafreeze team. For example, we can have Childe, then Kaeya, and for example, Diona, and then Sucrose. In that team, we have the Cryo Resonance, so we have more crit rate, and then Kaeya for the fast Cryo application, Diona for the shield, and then Sucrose for the like swirl and stuff like that. Now for a burst sub DPS Childe, as I said before, the only thing you're gonna need is to apply pyro before his elemental burst, because you'd wanna vaporize his burst to have like double of the damage, so that's like pretty necessary. Other than that, all of the teams are gonna be pretty flexible. A team example for that, we're gonna use any pyro main DPS, for example, Hu Tao or Yanfei, Klee, Yoimiya or whatever, like any of those. And then we're gonna use Xingqiu with them because we wanna vaporize all of their hits. We can add Xiong Ling and then Childe, for example. In that team, like the only use for Childe is gonna be, as I said, using his elemental burst for damage. It's not gonna be like that useful, to be honest, in this type of teams. Like you're just gonna be doing his burst and then leave, that's it. But he's still like usable. If you don't want to use him on the field for a long time, but you still want to use him, then you can use him in this type of teams. Alright, so that was the video guys. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel. If you want to say anything, or you got any other ideas, or you want to ask some questions, leave them in the comments, and see y'all in the next video. Peace.